Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best and Slot, and we are back playing Jurassic World, the game. We are going straight into the battle arena, first things first, to try and get ourselves a super rare Supersaurus, and then we're going to do what we said last episode, we're going to buy ourselves a few mystery packs, and then we're going to knock out a mission. Right, super, ooh, golly. 918 health, that is disgusting. It's a level 37 super rare. I might be in trouble here. Can the T-Rex take down a level? Can the T-Rex take down that? Let's compare. So I do plus 50%. So I do about 240 damage. He does about minus 50%, about 110. I'm just trying to plan this out in my head. That should be good enough. Let's find out, shall we? Ladies and gentlemen, the Supersaurus. They've got this thing with sauropods where they just stick spikes on the back and then just chuck colours at them, just cover them in a billion colours. We're going for it. We're just going crazy. That's nearly a kill right there. It's not quite a kill, but it's nearly a kill. Okay, it's not that close to a kill. I thought it was closer. This isn't a kill, is it? Oh, okay, might be in a little spot above it here. This is a kill, because he can't defend, I knew that. The problem is, I needed to be able to hit this Allosaurus with Metro Rankus built up, that was kind of the plan. I messed up a little bit. I'm hoping we're okay. This just has to die. If the Allosaurus dies, I win, essentially. In my head, that's how it works, because Benitosaurus is going to come out and kick Metrorhynchus in the face, but then Suchomimus comes out and destroys Benitosaurus, so easy peasy, lemon squeezy, right? Benitosaurus can block once, so as long as three hits is a kill, which it definitely is, there should be no problem. Slap, slap, slap. Doop, da doo, 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 doo. Is that Final Fantasy? Sorry about that little jutter there, guys. I don't really know what happened. I managed to briefly look up at my screen and I noticed that it completely, utterly frozen. I've got no idea why. I'm super sorry. I won the fight. It was pretty simple, I suppose. You heard me narrate and get, you can use your imaginations to imagine what happened. I do apologize. I had no idea. I don't know how to fix it. Shouldn't happen again. If it does, I'm just going to keep a beady eye on. Anyways, we have got ourselves a Supersaurus, who we're just going to go ahead and get started. Because it's 10 hours. It's a bloody long time. And who's next? Who's next? Guys! It's a Dimetrodon. It's a legendary Dimetrodon. It's a legendary... I'm pretty sure Dimetrodon in this game is amphibious. I know it's not amphibious in reality, but I'm pretty sure in this game it is an amphibious creature. We came up against one. Did we come up against one? I have no idea. Either way, it's another legendary in one more level, and we can get that level, hopefully, in this very episode. Move 5 buildings, right? I'm excited about that guy. Metrorhynchus is good and has done good work for me, but we have been kind of in need for something a little better, I think. I'm also noticing, we have a rather absurd amount of DNA. That's going to come in handy very soon. Buildings, done. Let's move some decorations. Checking the screen. Bloody hell. Checking the screen. There we go. You got 5 minutes to grab what you can. After that, we're gone. I'll drag you with me if need be. The storm outside is brewing mighty badly, and I, for one, don't want to get caught under it. I won't be long going. I promise. I get the feeling he's very sad inside. He's dead, theoretically, so. Miss Tearing, I have a message from Mrs. Hoskins for you. What is it? You can tell I can't do multiple female voices. They've never talked, as far as I can tell. He told me to tell you that he wanted to meet you in 1 hour by the bonfire in the square. Why can't he come to my office and tell me himself? I have my hands full at the moment. He He was very specific about it. That's the best I can do. Oh, Jesus wept. Are you kidding me? That's a crazy amount of dinosaurs at level 40. What? No. 10? 10? 10? 10? 10? That's insane. What? Right. Okay, let's not panic. Let's evaluate. Right, so Benitasaurus isn't far off. Benitasaurus needs 2 more Benitasaurus, and we've got a level 40 Benitasaurus. So we need to find 6 more candidates, and obviously they're going to be commons, because it just makes a lot more sense. Pelicanimimus isn't a bad candidate. We've got a... Guanlong is definitely going to be one of them as well. Alankwa's not a bad shout. Alankwa's one of our better ones in terms of levels. Limoncello is pretty good as well. Limoncello will be one of them. I should be counting these up, really, shouldn't I? Okay, that's, instead of worrying about the future, let's just focus on the ones we've got. Oh, and definitely Diplocalus as well. Okay, so that's a few. We've got some good stuff to work with. We're going to get ourselves 10 packs now, like we planned, and that will hopefully... It'll give us a lot of DNA for one, which will really help, but it'll also give us some new dinosaurs, which will help us make this decision. Colobo, I have 3 off, I think. Right, 1 pack. Please, just keep doing that. Keep giving me lots and lots of DNA. It's going to make me sad to spend the DNA on commons, but at this point in time, we pretty much have to. The game is very resistant sometimes to actually give me dinosaurs. If you want to keep giving me this much DNA in every pack, I am A-okay. Oh, what's that? Oh, Diplodocus, cool. Not going to be a level 40, but always nice to get a rare. Because Diplodocus has been there for bloody... I think Diplodocus was like the first rare we got. So been there for a very long time. What's that? Alankwa, good, good, good. Very helpful indeed. 4 more. Colobo becoming a possibility now that we've got a few of those on the way. Pelicanimimus was one of... The game is being very kind to me right now. It's very much... When we get a dinosaur, it is by and large giving me dinosaurs that I wanted. This is the last one we're going to get. Let's hope for something good. Dinosaur, what is it? Not particularly helpful. Okay. Rightio Skipperoony. Okay. I'm excited about this. I'm not worried about this. I'm excited. We're going to take it one critter at a time. And obviously that means we are starting with Benitasaurus. So let's get this evolved first. We've got a lot of DNA. We've got a lot of dino dollars. We can chuck some stuff at it and we can make this quest happen. Right, so we need 2 more Benitasaurus. Let's go get that sorted. Oh, they're going to be so expensive. If we speed up the Allosaurus, it'll actually save money long term. There you go, Al. Good old Al. Okay, Benitasaurus. Where are you, my dear? Where are you? Do I not have any Benitasauruses? Have I hatched them? I've hatched them all. Okay. Just need 2 more, and we can speed these up, we can power through this, we can get ourselves another, then it's going to be Guanlong, probably. Yeah, it's going to be good, this. It's making me really upset that we could have got a Spinosaurus, that we could have got a Velociraptor, that we could nearly get another Pteranodon. We could nearly get another T-Rex. I don't think it's worth it. This mission is going to be a royal pain, and I just want to smash it, you know? Plus, having 10 Mega Evolution Dinosaurs, that's going to be pretty cool. Oh, right, yeah. I was a little confused. I was like, did I do it already somehow? What's going on, game? You're making me very optimistic about something that I know is not true. Benita, where are you, my dear? There you are. Well, we're about to get ourselves a crazy-ass-looking sauropod. Let's get that on the go. We may as well get one of these. Are any of these going to be part of it? Yes, Alankwa. So let's get you hatching now while we work on this. Where are you? I'm a little worried we're going to run out of food more than anything else. That is the primary worry right now, I think. But let's see how far we can get. I don't think we're going to manage to get all of them in this episode. Oh, definitely not in this episode. Or all of them right now with the current stuff we have. But to be honest, guys, this is literally all we have left to do. There's no alternative plan, you know. There is nothing we can do until this mission is done at the end of the day, so... However, that will give me a bit of XP, which will help. I apologise, I'm going to try to tap this a little lighter. Bloody Nora, I haven't shut my window. I mentioned in the last episode, when I tap, it kind of sounds like somebody's knocking at my door, you know, when I play it through my big speakers, and it's terrifying, because one of our videos was auto-playing at one point, and all I remember was thinking someone was at the door at like 4 in the morning, getting up, dragging myself to the door, opening the door, and it's just this dead corridor. It was creepy though. I am going to run out of food before I run out of anything else here. Oh, maybe not. Oh, what are you doing, game? What are you doing? The thing is, in my head, we could just get to level 31, but we can't. We have to get it from 31 all the way up to 40. Hello, crazy Benitosaur. What are you? Oh, this is going to be a painful mission. It really is. 4 out of 10, though. 4 out of 10. We're on the way. Right, Alanqua, you're probably next. Okay, let me think. We still need... I've got one on the way. That's a level 10. That's level 20. That's level 20. So we still need 4 more Alanquas after this. Bloody Nora. This quest is horrible! Why have they put this in the game? It is such a huge jump in terms of requirements compared to everything we've ever done. It is a massive change. Absolutely massive. I can't get my head around it. I can't get my head around it at all. Okay, so we still need 3 more Alanquas, and that'll be enough. And then we'll probably do Pelican and Mimas next. Guanlong is going to be up there as well. I'm quite excited to see. I mean, we've never seen Alanqua in super form. We've seen the others. Guanlong, though, we know looks really, really cool. Let's get some of this done now. Guanlong, so I'm really excited to have a max level Guanlong. Just because of how it looks, and it just looks all feathery. It's like it's been to a gala. And that's exciting for some reason. God only knows why. Right. May as well talk about things. What can I talk about? I'd love to talk and ramble on sometimes, but you know what, guys? I don't do anything these days. Everything in my life for the past like a month has been dedicated to, has been absolutely dedicated to sort of getting ready for this trip. There's no room in my life for anything other than getting prepared for this trip now. It has become everything I know, you know. Level 10, level 10, level 20, yeah. 2 more. It's hard to really, I don't know, it's Friday as I record this. I'm in 3 days time, what time is it? I will be sitting in Frankfurt Airport. I was a bit of an idiot, I bought the wrong flight. The girl I'm going with, I'm going to talk about this briefly because people keep asking. I'm going with a friend of mine who I met at university, just a friend, who loves travelling and stuff as well, so we figured we may as well do it together since it, why not? And, yeah, she gets a 7, her flight is fine, it gets there at an appropriate time. I was meant to get a flight about 5 hours later than the one I am getting, so now I'm getting a ridiculously early morning flight so that I can sit in Frankfurt Airport for 8 hours. Sound, what are you doing? Let's go ahead and stop that for a second, shall we? I have a suspicion, right? You've just seen, everything's going a little bit crazier. Sound's gone a little crazy, things are freezing and stuff. Now, I mentioned a few episodes ago that I'd upgraded to Reflector 2, because it had just come out. And it was a bit laggier than Reflector, it didn't work as well. And I've actually downgraded back to Reflector 1 since then. Maybe the company behind Reflector have seen me using their old product, and they're like, no, you will upgrade, we shall ruin your Reflector until you do this properly. I will not fall for your plans. I will use the old Reflector Because it works! If you bring me one that actually works properly, then I'll use the bloody new one. Gotta say, I wish it recorded in widescreen as well. It does none of these things, but at the end of the day, I'm recording my iPad screen. It's pretty cool, I can't complain that much. Go on, go on, go on, no! I really thought that wasn't gonna make it again, I was ready to cry. Good old Alanqua. What's... Okie dokie. This will be number 5, and we already had 2. That's insane. I'm gonna record the review straight after I do this video, and I actually take issue with this quest. I think 5 would be an appropriate number. Now, considering I've put money into this game, you know, buying packs several times and all that kind of jazz, I cannot imagine, in my head, I cannot comprehend how horrible this quest must be for people who can't put money into the game, you know? This is the quest that is in the game to force you to put money into it. Because how do you do this if you are completely free to play? How do you possibly do this quest? Don't get me wrong, it's doable, but the time you would have to put in, it will take weeks. It will literally take weeks to do one quest with mediocre rewards. That's amazingly daft in my opinion. We're gonna have to buy more mystery packs, get more DNA, get more food. Oh, Mega Alanqua, it's got a little mohawk. To be fair, I quite like it. It looks realistic, you know? It looks like it could be viable as a creature. I like when they do that. Not many of them do it, but nah, Alanqua, I'm a big fan of your work. Congratulations, buddy. You're somewhat attractive. Not in that kind of way. I'm not going to take you out to dinner, but still. Have 10 out... 5 out of 10. Right, next up is Guanlong? We need 3 more Guanlongs, I think. So let's see how many... Whichever one we need more of, we'll go for. Oh, it's definitely Guanlong is way ahead of the fight. Right, Guanlong next. Bloody Nora. This is crazy. Guanlong! Boop! Boop, boop. We're just going to do this until I've got nothing left. Because at the end of the day, I don't need anything else anymore, you know? I have no need for food at the moment. I have no need for gold at the moment. I've got no need for DNA at the moment. Sorry for that little noise, by the way. Everything is now completely dedicated to getting this quest done because nothing else matters. I think we're going to run out of DNA shortly. Because whilst we do have enough to get all the Guanlongs, meow, meow, easy to do this, we do have the problem that it takes XP, DNA for them to sort of evolve as well. But I'm a big fan of this dinosaur in this game, so I'm okay leveling this little guy. Look at him go! That's what he sounds like. If they all work out well, we might just about manage it. It's going to be close. Love that noise. I love that noise. I know people keep telling me it's turtles and such things. I don't care. That just makes me scared of turtles, you know? My finger hurts, cause it keeps on tapping the same screen over and over again, and a partridge in a pear tree. Ow, ow, ow. This is insane! It's worth it to see many, many Guanlongs eat many, many... Okay, whatever. Don't know what this guy looks like at 21, so I think just a little bit more red, probably. Yes, ever so slightly more red. It's quite cool, actually. We can flip between them. Actually, it's less red of anything. Basically, the white patterning that we see between the red marks has been replaced by black splodges. On the plus side, this is going to do wonders for my gold generation. It really is. Going to do absolutely nothing for my battle potential. Absolutely nothing for my battle potential. But wonders for the gold, and I suppose that's what doesn't matter in the slightest. Oh my god. On the plus side, I have a mission that requires a high level Guanlong to actually enter the arena. So having a level 40 Guanlong is actually going to be pretty bloody helpful now that I think about it. Ladies and gentlemen, for those who missed it last time, Mega Guanlong. I really like it. I think it's really cool. I think the horn's a bit big. But otherwise, I think, you know, it's big feathery tail and stuff. It's very cool. And the body kind of has texture on it that it's quite hard to see, but it looks like it's downy feathers. Oh, for God's sake. Okay, hopefully, last time that'll happen. I actually think it's not a problem with Reflector. I think my iPad went a little bit crazy, probably because I've been neglecting her somewhat. Sorry, iPad. Anyways, to finish off, let's go ahead and... Go ahead, chap. Try to get Guanlong... Are we going to run out of food? Hooray! I really like it. Like I was saying, you can see this texture on it. It's kind of like downy feather. It's hard to spot, and obviously they can't like go full on feathers all over the body. It'd be quite hard to do and animate and such things, but whatever. I really like the Guanlong. I think it looks awesome. But there we go, ladies and gentlemen. Triple Mega Evolutions in one episode. We are now up to six. Wait. Yeah, triple. Yeah. Guanlong, Alankwa, and someone over here. Good old Benita Sora. That means we need to find four more. Let's find our final four Mega Evolutions. So one of them is going to be Pelicanimimus. Okay, well, Pelicanimimus has got a level 20, effectively, and a level 1. So let's see who competes with that. Utahraptor is actually next, because Utahraptor is actually in a slightly better position. Anybody else? Diplocaulus is definitely up there. Level 20, level 10... Diplocaulus is actually the best one at the moment, so Diplocaulus is going next. And I believe Limoncello is in a pretty good position to do this as well. I think that's our final four. Limoncello is in an okay position. We do have one more Colobo on the way, but I don't think it's enough. It's not. So our final four is going to be Pelicanimimus, Utahraptor, Diplocaulus, and Limoncello. Do we have any of those here? Got two more Colobos. Colobo, where are you? Where is it? I don't know. It's here somewhere. Is it there? Colobo's got four. That's two level 10s or a level 20. That's still not as good as any of these, I don't think. No. So next up... is Diplocaulus. Now we can do a bit of it now. Just carry on. We've got evolutions to do. Look at him, little baby. He's so adorable. Diplocaulus, I've had it for such a long time. We know what the Mega Evolution looks like for this guy. And I've got to be honest, I don't love it. It's very red, very stripy. It's basically like a Diplocaulus and a tiger got very, very close to each other one night. And maybe had a little bit too much wine, you know? So low on food, so low on DNA, so low on optimism for this quest. Gonna buy some packs. Lovely jubbly. So we need three more Diplocaluses, if my maths is correct. Yeah. If this hasn't done wonders for my gold generation, I'm going to be very upset. And actually... No, never mind. In fights where there's multiple carnivores, it'll be quite nice having another level 40 amphibious creature. Now, it's not going to be as good as Metrorhynchus, but just having two of them at a decent level will come in handy. Level 21 Diplocaulus, also brand new. So basically, the Mega Evolution looks like this, but with a spine sail thing on the back. Let's get a few more packs. You little stunner. It's like they knew. It's like Christmas. How did you know? How did you know that's all I ever wanted? Not as helpful, admittedly. Can't win them all, eh? Although, I say that. Oh. It's a Kalimimus! That's so cool! Sorry. saying that about the whole that's not that helpful thing, it kind of is in a way. Because what we can do with the ones we don't need is potentially flog them for DNA points. Although we want to level everyone up anyway, so. How do I sell you? Go away. Packs, 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 packs. Everybody loves packs. Oh. Cool. Two rares. Not helpful, but cool. Helpful would be a Diplocaulus. Not an Elankra. Elankra is the opposite. We're selling the Elankra. Let's put it that way. So the Elankra is essentially worth DNA, nothing else. Pelicanimaris, that's the kind of stuff we need. A few more of those and we are golden. Colobo is rising up in the ranks. I'm going to have to do a little research. Triceratops. Also useless, means we can sell it. That means we've got 5 Colobos. Because we've got 3 over here in this. I think. Yeah. It's a 5. Right, let me just do one more check. I've got to double check this. It's costing so much that it's important to make sure we're doing this correctly. So, 5 of those. We've got 1 Diplocaulus on the way, so we've got 2... 6 Diplocauluses. So Diplocaulus wins ahead of that, plus I've already spent food on it anyway, so it's mainly got to beat the others. Now we've got a Pelicanimimus in there, which means we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 Pelicanimimuses. Which means thingamajiggy, Colobo has actually taken over Pelicanimimus as the next priority. Who were our other selections? Because I cannot remember already. Limoncello was one of them. 1, 2, 3, 4. Colobo has risen up the ranks. Colobo is going to be one of them now. Then we'll have to decide which one we knock out for... We need 4 more, don't we? One of them is going to be Diplocaulus. One of them is definitely going to be Utahraptor, because we've got 1, 2, 3, 4... Again, 4. We've got 3 of dinosaurs that are on 4, and 1 that's on 5. Colobo's in, so it means either Utahraptor, Pelicanimimus, or Limoncello are out. And Utahraptor I definitely want to keep. So, interesting. I didn't actually think this would be an issue. I didn't think Colobo would manage to get so many copies of itself that it would factor into this decision. But he has gone ahead and done it with aplomb. 220s and a 10 from Colobo without getting any new ones. 220s? No. Got 3 more on the way. How many do you need to get level 40? 2 for level 20. 2 for level 20. So it's 8. Yeah, so we need 3 more Colobos. Okay. Right. I am going to do something. What I'm probably going to do is spend... I'm going to stop throwing dollars at it now. So we're going to spend the time and just let these guys naturally come in. So when we pick up the next episode, hopefully, we'll basically have all 8 Diplocauluses, all 8 Colobos, all 8 Utahraptors, every dinosaur we need in order to get the evolutions done. We'll probably have to buy another selection of packs, and then we'll go from there. I'm going to try to do it today, hopefully, but we shall see. Either way, that will be on... That episode will be on Monday, after our normal resume of Primal Carnage Extinction, which is going to be back, because normal service will resume. Cool. Thank you very much for joining me. I do apologize for the little issues. I think restarting my iPad has fixed the majority of them. Let's pray. But yeah, thank you so much for joining me for the entirety of Jurassic World Week. I've had a great time with the game. It's a fantastic little game. I am kind of excited to go play other things as well. We have another mobile dinosaur game on the way starting on Tuesday, and another animal-based normal game, which is awful in the first episode, and then you get to the second episode, and I realise a billion things, and the game gets substantially cooler. So it's all good. Thank you for joining me. Cheers. Much love, as always. Bye-bye. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Bastion Slot, and today I'm going to do a quick, hopefully quick, I say that a lot and never is, a quick review of Jurassic World, the game, by Ludia, the makers of Jurassic Park Builder. And that is an important note to make right now. This game, for those who haven't been watching the series or whatever on the channel, is very, very, very similar to Jurassic Park Builder in most of the key ways. You collect dinosaurs, you level them up by giving them food, and then they essentially evolve sort of set level intervals until they max out at level 40. That's all the same. There's also battling in the game and missions that you get as you level up. All those conceits that you know from Jurassic Park Builder are exactly the same. If you play Jurassic Park Builder, you'll be able to hop into Jurassic World the game with very little issue. Things like expanding there as well. Now the differences, well, it's been streamlined a little bit for a start. For one, food is now a single thing. Oh, you're lagging, aren't you?